This is the Seedco vegetable stand, and we are here this morning to just showcase to the world what we offer. And we hope that all of you that are going to go around with me, you'll be able to learn one or two things. First of all, I will start with the green peppers on my right. As I get closer, and I would really want the cameraman to really, you know, show us, you know, the best that can be. So this is Hecus peppers. As you can see, they have just started, you know, giving the very nice fruits. This is very interesting. I think for the farmer, what is really important is the amount of fruit that you are able to get from each particular plant. I can actually count 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, some of them are even hidden in the leaves. So the leaf cover actually protects these particular peppers from the heat because of a problem which is called a sun scald. Apart from that, would come closer here to another variety which is called Solana. This is a yellow variety under Seedco. Sweet pepper Solana F1. It's a hybrid variety. You can actually see it here. It's already yellow. It has started turning the color into yellow. This is Solana. First of all, I can hear the ton. It's quite hard. This is very nice for the peppers. And even when you put it in the shelf, you not get it, you know, get spoiled within a short time. So the hardness is very good. And apart from that, we have the red one, which is a red prime. So this one as well, you can actually hear again, it's also a hard one. So these are the peppers that Seedco vegetables have. And as you can see, maybe just come closer here, closely. You're able to see the yellowing already. This signifies that you know, production is almost there. Actually, these ones are more or less like twins, you know, married to each other like this. This is very beautiful. So these are Solana, you know, F1 sweet pepper that Seedco vegetables had. You can see actually the massive growth of these particular crops. They're actually doing extremely well. This is what is required for the farmer. And you can see you also need to stake your peppers to ensure that they are protected from the ground, because as they start, you know, coming out, they need to be protected. And this is the reason why you have got the strings, you have got the twine to protect them very, very well. Now we move to my favorite crop called tomato. As I am called Mr. Tomato, it's very encouraging to see that Tomato Candela is also lying. And I can see when you get down there, there are quite a number of fruits that are actually lying down, which actually signifies that this farmer is going to get the best of the best. You know, the first thing that you'd want to learn from Tomato Candela is that it's a crop that actually gives good fruits. As you can see here, if I start counting here, you know, my minutes may not just be enough to actually finish counting, because, you know, the beautiful of the fruit, first of all, it's the hardness of the fruit. The second thing is that now they have started turning into red. And this is exactly, you know, 79 days, you know, from planting. It was planted in December, and we are talking about 79 days of today. This is a beautiful, you know, cluster of fruits that you are able to see from one particular cluster, and you are able to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You are able to get about 12 fruits from one cluster of Candela F1. It's a hybrid variety, indeterminate, grows massively and gives the farmer quite a lot of fruits. And apart from that, you are able to harvest for about 5 to 6 months. This is very interesting, and you know, as we get on to this business, it's important for you farmers to get to grow, you know, Tomato Candela. And one other thing is that already it's turning into red. This is the deep red color that every marketeer is actually looking for. So as you begin your production of tomatoes in this country, this is the tomato to go for. Tomato Candela is here to give the farmer money. It's here to give the farmer the quality. It is here to give the farmer sustained business. So you're able to keep on growing from season to season, and you actually can grow it throughout the year. This time that we are talking about now, we are getting into winter. This crop is also going to go into winter. And next time, we'll be back here again to show you that this crop can actually grow into winter. We have another variety called Alhambra F1. Very interesting variety so far from Seedco vegetables. First of all, it's also an indeterminate variety. It also grows very well. As you can see, the fruits are already forming here. Very interesting fruits, clusters are already there. One beautiful thing about Alhambra is that it actually gives you, the farmer, quite a number of fruits. As we can come down here with me, You are able to see here that the fruits are forming. This is Candela tomato. First of all, it's also very hard. The shelf life is very good. You're able to keep it for 14 days without rotting. And apart from that, it's able to stand very well in the ground. And apart from that, it's able to grow tall as, you know, more than some of us. I mean, it will go beyond 3 meters. It will keep growing. But I think the most important thing that the farmer should know is that this crop can be grown throughout the year. This crop can also give the farmer good money. And apart from that, it's also a crop that, you know, some of you that are, you know, supplying supermarkets and chain stores, this is the variety to go for. Because it doesn't really, you know, it has got the green shoulders. It has got green shoulders. What it means is that, you know, you still have your green coloring even when you put it in the shelf. Anywhere that you are, if you are in the chain stores, or you're somebody that wants that, there are certain farmers or certain consumers, sorry, that would want to have something that is not completely ripe. This is the variety to go for. And apart from that, we're not just finished with the business. We've got the cucumbers, English cucumbers for that matter. As you can see, I'll hold it from one end to the other end. Yesterday when I got a measurement, we were trying to measure this particular, you know, cucumber variety, which is called Dreamliner. It was actually giving us between 38 and 40 centimeters, right? Yes, between 38 and 40 centimeters from one end to the other end. One important thing about the English cucumbers is that these are mostly eaten fresh. And I would love to share one important lesson that we should learn. When you delay your cucumbers in the field, they will develop into something that may not be desirable. As you can see the colors here, this we deliberately left it like this because we wanted you, the farmers, to know that when you delay it for some time, it will start turning yellow. And as it turns yellow, it actually turns the taste of the cucumber. It's supposed to be green in color like this. By the way, from the time of planting up to the time of harvest, this particular crop took about 55 days thereabout. And right now, as we are talking, it's now going into 70 days from the time of transplanting it. So you're able to see that when you delay it for some time, you'll be able to have this particular problem. But the good thing is that the few months that you're going to harvest your cucumbers, the moment it ripens, just remove it. You're not going to experience this particular problem. Then you can continue harvesting. Some people have even harvested for more than 14 weeks continuous harvest from English cucumber. This is also one of our products that Seedco Vegetables has. And we hope that with these few minutes that I've shared with all of you, you'll be able to pick one or two lessons from there. And we always say, it starts with the right seed. Thank you.
Thank you.
Shalom, shalom.
That was a nice one.